unprecedented describes most things about the Donald Trump administration. One unique element, the presence of the president's daughter, Ivanka Trump, and her relationship to First Lady Melania Trump. Glamorous stepmother and stepdaughter since 2005, but it was 2016 during the Trump presidential campaign.
My father, Donald J. Trump.
When the dynamic between the two women shifted to politics. Most times on the campaign trail,
hello, Iowa.
Melania Trump, not interested in doing traditional spousal appearances. So it was Ivanka Trump, as surrogate, who stepped into the role.
I just want to thank you, honey, because great job.
Staying on as the female face of the administration and the family after Trump became president.
This is the first U.S. government, all of government, approach to empowering women in the developing world.
Hello. Taking on as senior advisor some of the more traditional First Lady issues involving women, child care credit, and female entrepreneurship.
A real power named Ivanka. And she would call me and she would say, Daddy, you don't understand. You must do this. You must. And I said, oh.
Creating an odd dynamic, switching off front seat, back seat as the two women in Trump's orbit. A relationship that one source with knowledge of the relationship says has created a, quote, cordial but not close dynamic, and at times, friction. There are similarities that have reportedly caused static.
This is a very special place. I will never forget.
Melania Trump's first big solo trip was to Africa, and Ivanka's first big solo trip was also to Africa. Melania Trump was the first to introduce highly produced mini videos of her events for public consumption. Ivanka now makes her own short films with voiceovers and music. On trips with Trump, when Melania goes, Ivanka's profile diminishes. When she doesn't,
Mike, Beauty and the Beast, Mike.
Ivanka often steps forward. In a way, splitting the traditional norms, but sharing one key component.
I give him many advices, but, you know, sometimes he listens, sometimes he doesn't.
They both have the ear of the president.
I'm candid in my opinions, and I share them, solicited or otherwise.
Kate Bennett, CNN, Washington.